Roll call. Pass building.
Mike and Helen.
Kevin Levin.
Martinez, LAPD.
Officer Flores.
Javier Calvillo, Joe Donport.
Brittany Garza, Street Quest.
Joel Howard, Crystal Enterprise.
Move to approve the meeting minutes from our previous meeting.
Yes, I do.
All in favor?
Public comment, we got a card from our senior lead officers, Alvarez, now Fred Martinez. President.
Hello guys, I'm Officer Martinez. The senior lead officer from, I come from 3rd Street to 9th Street, Spring Street to Figueroa. My partner here, Alvarez, covers basically my area just a little bit more. We're just here to give updates. Al's been off, hurt, so now he's back. And now we're gonna try to work on the streets a little bit more. Try to work on the palm areas that we have, like on 5th and Spring, 6th and Spring, and work on the transit that we're dealing. Deal with our narco units, our bike units, the abandoned buildings on 419 South Spring, 433 South Spring. And we also wanted to bring it up as far as the camera system. The camera system that was up, it's about 12 years old. And I just spoke with our tech guys from Central Station, and to replace the camera, it's gonna be about $8,000 per camera, a piece, yeah, per camera. But the cameras, these, I don't know how it works, but with this new technology, we don't need to wait, basically a repeater. All it is you put it up, it'll wait to 6th and Spring, 6th and San Pedro, and it'll relay the feed, and the camera is amazing. If you guys have time, if you guys want to go down to Central Station, I'll show you guys the camera system. It's really good, but we can work on it on 5th and Spring, wherever we have palms. So if you want to get up and move it, we can move it and work on our palms if you guys would like. And that's, I just want to bring it up to you guys. I know we're going to start getting parts of new division. I don't know if you guys heard, Central Division is going to get a little bit bigger. We're going to cover from 7th Street all the way south to Washington. Before, we only covered just 7th Street and parts of to Washington. Now we're going to, from basically from the 110 freeway all the way to the bridge to Washington, and we're going to get that whole industrial area where Coca-Cola's at, and a bunch of factories there, and the people down there, they're getting like 8 to 10 new cameras that they're paying for to get a lot of people.
Are you going to get more resources to handle?
Yeah. Oh, yes, we're going to get, I think, I don't know the details, but it's like 30 officers, another show, 5 sergeants, like 6 detectives, and that all comes with cars, everything. So that's where we're at right now, and I just want to get you guys as far as the cameras. They work for us as far as monitoring them and working with solving crimes. So
putting a speaker, then I see you.
That would be awesome. That'll be an extra
Great, there should be a speaker.
Yeah.
No. What's the distance? How many feet can you zoom? What's the angle of? I know it's not face recognition. We're not in China, but like, I mean, you can pretty much get a good image of a face if something's going on.
Yes, these new cameras.
Yeah.
I just saw them yesterday, and they're amazing. They said you could actually read a credit card number off
the. Oh, that's great. Yeah. So that's really good.
You guys were on board when
yes.
Ownership.
It was a long time ago. Yes.
So
yeah.
I guess the question is, with kind of the pitches, more cameras would come in.
Right. Are any of those cameras still working or?
They're so old.
No, they're so old.
They do work.
Yeah.
But the pixels are so old just to get any camera, it's better to just put up one of those cameras.
Uh-huh.
And I mean, they're gonna have straight cable.
That's color, I presume.
Yes.
Uh-huh. Do you still have a little substation at the Loomis, you know, on Main Street? You had a little between 5th and 6th on Main.
No.
Uh-huh.
But you're more than welcome to go to the station, so it's like to show you.
Just curious.
Yeah.
What about, how's 5th and Broadway since 7-Eleven closed? Is it a little bit better?
That's a lot better.
A lot better.
Uh-huh. Now we're working on 5th and Hill, and there's still a problem at 5th and Hill. And the problem is from 5th and Hill to the amphitheater to Skid Row is like
I
the walkthrough. So the main thing, we've been getting our bikes and our narcotics unit to hit them up a little bit harder to try to work on the cracks that are occurring.
Yeah.
So
I've been here 29 years, so I've seen it was worse back in the 90s. You know, it's always been.
I've been at since Central Division since 2004. I remember Main Street was just as bad.
Yeah.
If you told me people were going to be walking their dogs at midnight,
I know. Yeah, I that's to everyone.
Yeah.
You know, when how it was when our guards were armed back then, and it's changed. I mean, it's, I know the crime's it's gone up a little lately, but.
And as far as the clubs, we're also trying to get the clubs at night, the nighttime crowd, because that's, you know, we're having problems there as well. But we're working on it, and feedback from you guys would be great also.
Thank you. So you guys, the low violent crime in our area right now is down 4.5% from last year, and then our property crimes are down 3.6%. from last year.
At the same time,
correct.
5 months.
One of the things that we get in the area, unfortunately, are breaking into cars. People are still leaving property in their vehicles, and we have a lot of people out there who,
they leave stuff in the car.
Take that handbag, I'm going to take extra change,
exactly.
Whatever they're going to do. Property, same thing, a lot of unattended items, so anything we can do to get that message out to people. We're going to do a coffee with the cops pretty soon, either on 6th and Spring at the Starbucks, or the one here on 5th and Hill. Get the community out. One of the things in order for us to reach everybody is community. Just talk to the community, get involved with the community. Today we had one with Officer Rudy, and it was really successful. A lot of people from the community showed up, and they get to talk to the officers, and they see, certain concerns that they have, they don't feel that comfortable how he was. But when we're in an environment like that, drinking coffee, talking, people are a little bit more relaxed. So that's the number one thing that we want to do. Talk to the community and get our message out. Any questions?
There's a bunch of car break-ins, which I know has been a trend lately.
Yes.
Do you perceive it as like maybe a random one person, and then because it seems like there's an arrest and then they stop?
You know, unfortunately, we've been seeing in our crime maps, it's throughout. It's not one cluster. It's just very random.
And we also had one. We had one a couple of months ago where the guy had $10,000. He was going to go to Vegas, leaves his car, comes back out, they had $10,000. So he came back and told his buddies, hey, I found $10,000. There was a lot of break-ins within those couple of days because they thought they were going to keep money. So they go out and they tell their friends and they spread the word and everybody starts breaking in the cars. That's the problem we have. So it's just not one person, it's a range of people.
So this is why I'm late, because I met with Officer Reed right before coming here.
Okay.
We had, in just this last weekend, in one of our facilities down on 8th and Long.
Is that 808, sir?
808.
Yeah.
Four break-ins in that facility. Well, typically, it's pretty quiet. They don't have any games. And what they're doing is, in many cases, is just smashing a window and grabbing stuff that they see within the vehicle. In a lot of cases, though, they're just smashing windows like nothing.
Yeah.
They're not seeing it. That doesn't make sense. And these guys are right that we have on camera, we have an African American male on camera, we have a Hispanic male on camera, they have a team of two Armenian people that are hidden over by Target in that area, guy and a girl. So it's like it's all over the board. And so was it like almost 50 some breaking?
There was a
the last
how many
night.
Were, He has a chin.
In the last few days. And so we just had one last night, matter of fact.
Oh, really?
Here on 449 behind this building. Yes. Here. We had a same deal. It's nationally the ground one.
It's just opportunistic.
It's very opportunistic.
Kevin, is it the bottom structure or is it street level?
Well, last night was the surface lot that was right here on Spring
449. Okay.
But in many cases, it's in the garages.
Yeah.
And it's in Class A buildings. It's in the Target.
Down the Target.
Over by the 7th and Fay.
Yeah.
And that's where they have pictures of an Armenian.
Armenian cop.
Yeah, what they think of Armenian.
So you guys can see, you know, the map of Central Division. You're saying you look for clusters and certain things. This is how the map looks different.
This is a burglar.
Burglar for more vehicles. That's the map. You know, we're gonna we know about that because Officer Reed is gonna be telling us.
That's part of my area too. We're gonna try to do a little bit extra patrol. And like I said, like my partner was saying, the community. Everybody that works and lives down here, you guys are our eyes. If you guys don't say something,
right.
If you see something, say something. Because we can just talk to him, have a consensual with them, and find out what he's doing in the parking lot. So it's just...
We got a good film on, too.
Oh, good.
Actually doing. And and for the most part, too, for bids, they're responsible outside. It's the sidewalk. They're not really supposed to come in the building. They don't have that responsibility. So we're going to beef up our... We have a contractor that we contract out scared to beat that up and have them do more patrols, but the bids can only do so much because they're pretty much on the exterior.
Are they stealing mostly when they see belongings in a car, I imagine? I mean, they don't break into a car where they don't see any
Sometimes it's very random. They have one break just for no reason.
But not really, they don't see anything, but they break in anyway.
Right. Last night on this surface lot over here on 449 Spring, they just broke the window.
And there was nothing sitting down, on the chair on the
Whatever.
They're wearing a hoodie or they're just
I don't have film on this one. Are they wearing
something or just
they look like dressed like
Are they wearing
He looks like any one of us that wears regular clothes. He's got a backpack.
Mm-hmm.
He like walks in the facility with nothing. He walks out with like two big bags and stuff. So
he knows where the camera is?
What's that? Well, this is all very new. I'm sure they're working on it.
There's video. So what happens is they put a crime bulletin out for this person, and if somebody knows them or stopped them, because a lot of these guys are repeat offenders. Mm-hmm. So you see them. Oh, that's so-and-so. I stopped him the other day. His name is so-and-so. Then there's a warrant out for the
Do you know who this man is?
Not yet.
No, not yet.
I
have
seen the video.
Just an image.
One thing that I've heard anecdotally throughout the city, I know randomly a bunch of people I know this has happened to, that people are finding somehow the mail key, like the key from the post office, to get into the building.
Yeah.
Stealing cars, stealing mail, stealing packages, stealing... They're breaking into homes. I mean, really, really crazy. And it's similar, it's like organized, very organized, and not homeless, like...
Yeah, right. I mean, that's really crazy. I mean...
I don't know, is that... But like, I've heard 10 stories, literally 10 stories of that in the last 2 months.
You know, and I've seen it on the news too. I mean, it's just, it's organized crime. I mean, you just gotta attention when,
So the other thing too is I sit on the board for the LA Parking Association. Unfortunately, all the groups here downtown, and I sent them out a message, giving them a heads up, saying, "Hey, if we can reiterate the word out there, get an eye hole down, out of view, then you know, it's gonna open it out." That's too well. That's like all the parking operators.
Or put them in the. My thing is put them in the trunk.
Right.
Outside of
Before you park.
Yes.
Right.
You
want to
be sure.
Yeah. Before you park.
So I'm happy to be back. It was not a year. It was longer than a year.
Yeah.
So it's like $12,000.
Thanks, mate. Thank you. Did she, Zuri's wife sold it to them? Oh, okay.
Hey, thank you very much for having me. I'll speak on behalf of Chris Wiss with the clean team.
I just want to give you guys an update on how things are going out there. One of the big things that's taken up a bunch of extra time for our workers and leadership is the grease dancer. And so those grease spots go down, he starts dancing. It takes 20, 25 minutes just to break down that grease buildup, and it's happening what feels like more and more.
I mean, it's happening. I've had a discussion with him, and he, you know, I'm like, it's cool as a dance, you're just going to wheel down because people slip and fall.
Yep. So we're trying to address that as quick as we can because people are, even our workers, as they're trying to break down the grease, are also slipping, you know, trying to prevent accidents happening while we're cleaning. So it's a real issue. I was talking with one of our workers who's been in the district for a long time and just kind of seeing his digression in terms of like start out just kind of friendly dancing spontaneously and has kind of developed into more and more. So something that we're continuing to spend a bunch of time addressing. Also Broadway, trying to stay up on planting and plants out here. I mean, they're just getting stolen constantly. So that's just kind of the constant maintenance and updates that are needed with a city full of people.
You think stolen to be used or just to the, for the hell of it, just knocking it off, pulling it out? I mean, I know it's hard to say.
I mean, I would guess people are just pulling them, just to pull them. You know, or maybe they put them next to their sidewalk spot or something.
So
we're addressing those things. Also though, if you guys have any special events that come up, anything that needs an extra bit of attention, that is something that we're continuing to address. If you guys can give us a day's notice, that's ideal. Make sure we have the pieces lined up. But just this morning, there's a big event at a building going on. So making sure that we're able to give like pressure washing attention for a wash down and everything. So if you at your buildings ever have anything coming up, we just want it to shine a little bit more, let us know. Call the hotline here and they'll relay the message. So I am getting married in June, which I'm super excited about. Hopefully the first and only time, right?
Yeah, exactly.
So looking forward to marrying her, but then we're actually gonna move and start fresh in the Midwest. We're moving to Minneapolis. So next week, it's awfully cold. So we're up and moving out there. So that takes me away from Chrysalis. Chrysalis makes it hard to leave though. It's a fantastic organization after 4 years of being there. I'm really proud to have worked there. So I hope that your guys' relationship with them continues to grow and flourish. VP Trevor Kale will be here at the next meeting and moving forward, make sure that you guys are all on the same page in terms of the transition plan. So we already have the next director of operations. They've been here longer than I have. Grace Davis is her name, and she's fantastic. So thanks again for having me. It's been great to be here. And keep putting out great spreads, because you know, it makes it fun to come. Thanks guys.
More women, more people come out of town, just more people in general. This last month he was able to get 5 people services for housing, and in the first quarter of this year he was able to get 30 housing services, connected housing services.
Did he say out of town or out of state? And you want to let them know?
This is also my last board meeting. It's been great. Yeah. I love working for the bid. I genuinely appreciate every minute of being here.
We have no more say?
I'll be staying, but I'm just moving over to LAY.
LAY. Well, you don't think you want to have so much to do there.
Yeah, I think it might be a
little bit. I mean, that's pretty plain. We need the big, we're the ones who really need the clean and safety and so
forth. Don't be modest, tell them what you're doing.
Yeah.
So
security manager for LAY.
Oh, good.
And I'm doing the big one.
No, not for software. Yeah, I would not be leaving for another
bit.
Yeah. Thank you.
Congrats.
Okay. We'll that up. All right, Cyrus,
do
you want to talk about the connector, the West End
connector? Yeah, well, Michael was thinking about, like maybe regrouping also on the historic core side, the same direction that goes to Alameda and 7, also extended on this side. It would be a very good idea. That was the discussion we had.
I think based on the options, based on the options that they had, explain that again. You said you need some rerouting to...
Well, not rerouting. I mean, it goes to extend the media on the also on this side, on the historical floor. If there is a possibility.
So to connect it up there and also...
Yeah. Also, Abdullah, I want to, because our security, but this is for the landlord, our security, for different buildings, we actually exchange information, when we see a suspicious person, somebody that is trying to vandalize, we immediately notify other buildings and other security people. I think there's a way that the building owner of different security companies, they can exchange their phone numbers to their security desk. If there is a suspicion person going from one building to another and they can recognize, they can actually give a call, no matter if it's a different security company, that they can actually tell their security people to look for that person. This happens so many times that when they're not successful in one building, they try to go and vandalize another building. So if you know the person and you call the security, they will really know in advance how to do it and how to deal with it.
So we had because
we I think it would be nice if the security companies, they can exchange phone numbers.
Yeah.
So in case when there is a suspicious activity, a suspicious person walking around with a group, sometimes they are in a group. We encounter them so many times, and we call our other companies or other buildings and tell them, look for these people.
That's a good idea. We can all work together.
Yeah, then you work with each other.
There's only a few security companies. In the larger buildings, actually, it's a great idea.
It would be a very, very good idea.
It's a
very easy task.
It's not
something that we need to spend money
on. I mean, a dozen security companies down here or so.
Very easy to handle.
They can leave it at the lobby, at the desk.
Put everybody on with server or something.
Yeah, something like that.
We could put pictures at the lobby desk, for
faces.
Or,
immediately,
they can email it to.
To us because they were going to Broadway.
When
they called the Broadway, and they cut them.
They called them. That's good.
That's good.
Julie Donovan. The other thing I wanted to make you guys aware of, there's going to be a county meeting where they're presenting on a proposed consolidated correctional facility, which is supposed to replace the men's central jail. They have never come to the downtown community, so it will be presented in a couple weeks. We'll all
make sure that you guys call, you know, just to make your folks aware that they should come. It's just to listen to the presentation of what they are proposing and then offer any community input. It's something that, you know, traditionally the city, the county, and the state are not great about notification and community input. So
you said that was for a mental institution, or you said correctional facility?
It's for a correctional facility, but there's going to be an emphasis on mental illness. And substance use.
Yes.
And as it relates to incarcerated individuals.
What's the address of the
Weatherman Center?
It's Weatherman Center.
Oh, okay, over there.
They're going to knock that down, they're going to build like a 2,000 bed.
It's
a jail, but yeah, the people in there are only the mentally ill people.
I understand, or, right, or drugs.
You all have an extra packet inside your board packets. These are to be kept still, you know, confident. They're all mock-ups, so nothing is final. Learned continues to work very closely with Brown Culture. They are the PR firm that's doing pro bono work for the design of our new marketing materials, and the idea is to continue in this beautiful rebranding that we've had. If you sit through the packet, you will see mock-ups for posters that can be placed strategically inside specific buildings that can be actually used as for the lamppost posters and banners. There's also at the end of the pages, there's some marketing materials like little buttons that can highlight different areas of the store or tote bags, things of that nature. So all of that will be coming in the next few months. The only other update is, as a function of the bid, we have ShopWalk, which is currently hosted inside the Spring Arcade during our walk night. Amara, who manages ShopWalk, is looking to manage ShopWalk, brought the idea to us of having a ShopWalk summer block party, specifically designated on a Sunday in line with farmers market to highlight the businesses on the 6th Street corridor. The 6th Street is a little further, but those are going to get as much love. It's difficult to get to them. So that will happen on Sunday, July 8th, from 11 a.m. to 3 p.m. We will be closing down 6th Street between Main and LA. And all of the businesses there will have different pop-up activations, there'll be brunch, there'll be specials hosted by those businesses. Christy and Gooch is going to have a little doggy daycare, they're going to be doing different activities. And there's a possibility to activate or reactivate Artisan House, the vacant space that was Artisan House, and have different DJs and music and other vendors, actual ShopWalk vendors, come and showcase their work that day. It's free for anyone to enter. The bid will be promoting it very heavily, and it'll also be obviously to, you know, bring more awareness to that area. All it is.
I move to adjourn the meeting. Thank you all for showing up.
Yeah.